Tasmanian devils return to mainland Australia for first time in 3,000 years. Antarctic ozone hole is more than twice the size of the United States. First measurements of radiation levels on the moon. And an Earth-sized planet is floating around the Milky Way without a star. Welcome to the What the Facts channel. This is Science News Summary, where we will cover the most interesting news about everything science-related that happens during the last week. Our topics range from medicine, neurology, and biology, to physics, technology, and space. So if you've had enough negativity in the press and you're looking for some uplifting news, then this show is just for you. Let's get started. For the first time in 3,000 years, the Tasmanian devil is back in the wild in mainland Australia. A historic moment that is critical to rewild Australia, the country with the world's worst mammal extinction rate. Actor Chris Hemsworth, who played Thor in the Avengers movies, has been supporting the conservationists' work. Hand in hand with his wife Elsa Pataki, they took active part in releasing some of the first Tasmanian devils on the mainland. The reintroduction plan has been led by a non-profit organization, Aussie Arc, which has been breeding the marsupials for a decade in an effort to save the species from extinction. Conservationists hope to track the reproductive traits and behavior of the devils, which have been fitted with radio collars, in anticipation of the 2021 breeding season. Two more releases of 20 animals each are planned over the next 2 years. According to Australian Geographics, the devils existed on mainland Australia for 40,000 years, until around the time the dingo, a medium-sized wild dog, was introduced on the continent. However, some studies suggest that the arrival of Aboriginal populations and a shift in climate were to blame as well. Additionally, a transmissible, painful, and fatal disease called devil facial tumor disease decimated up to 90% of the wild population of Tasmanian devils. So today, only 25,000 devils are left in the wild. The reintroduction of the carnivorous creatures can help control feral cats and foxes that threaten other endangered and endemic species. And because they are scavengers, they help keep their home clean and free of disease, added Global Wildlife Conservation during the release. The annually occurring ozone hole over the Antarctic is one of the largest and deepest in recent years. Analyses show that the hole has already reached its maximum size. According to the World Meteorological Organization, the 2020 ozone hole grew rapidly from mid-August and peaked at 24 million square kilometers, approximately 9.3 million square miles, in early October. This means the hole is larger than the average for the past decade and extends over most of Antarctica. However, it is already contracting and is now at 23 million square kilometers, around 8.9 million square miles. The large ozone hole in 2020 has been driven by a strong, stable, and cold polar vortex, which kept the temperature of the ozone layer over Antarctica consistently cold. Ozone depletion is directly related to the temperature in the stratosphere, where the ozone layer sits, because the polar stratosphere clouds that play an important role in the process only form at temperatures below minus 78 degrees Celsius, or minus 108.4 Fahrenheit. Ice crystals in the clouds react with compounds in the atmosphere that can then rapidly destroy ozone when they are exposed to sunlight, the WMO said. The ozone layer is Earth's natural defense against the effects of ultraviolet radiation from the sun. Found between 12 and 31 miles, or 20 and 50 kilometers, up in the planet's stratosphere, this layer of colorless gas absorbs the harmful components of ultraviolet B, or UVB. This radiation is dangerous because it can cause skin cancer, lower immunity, and damage eyesight. The moon is the next stepping stone for human space exploration, and several nations have announced plans for its exploration by humans. However, space radiation exposure is one of the major risks for astronauts' health, as the exposure to galactic cosmic rays may have late health effects, such as induction of cancer or degenerative diseases of the central nervous system or other organ systems. And though the Apollo mission astronauts carried dosimeters to the moon to measure radiation, the data was never reported. The problem was that the devices captured total exposure from their entire journey, not merely their time on the moon's surface. This means that we have never actually measured radiation exclusively on the moon. The first systematically documented measurements of radiation on the moon were undertaken in January 2019, when China's Chang'e 4 robotic spacecraft mission landed on the far side of the moon. According to a new study in the journal Science Advances, astronauts would get 200 to 1,000 times more radiation on the moon than what we experience on Earth, or 5 to 10 times more than passengers on a transatlantic airline flight, scientists noted. In comparison to the International Space Station, the moon radiation is about 2.6 times higher. The radiation levels described in the study are similar to levels that models have already predicted. Kerry Lee, NASA radiation expert, added, that the measurements agree nearly exactly with those made by a detector on a NASA orbiter that has been circling the moon for more than 10 years. And that it is nice to see confirmation of what we think, and that our understanding of how radiation interacts with the moon is as expected. And here is the last piece of news for this week. A team of astronomers has found a lone planet the size of Earth drifting through the Milky Way. Known as a rogue planet, it is unbound to any star. And astronomers say it is likely to drift through interstellar space forever. Finding rogue planets is, however, extremely challenging because unlike stars, planets do not have a light of their own. The planet is called OGLE-2016-BLG-1928 and was discovered by the scientists using optical gravitation lensing in collaboration with astronomers from Korea. Gravitational lensing requires two things: a distant light source, usually a star, and a closer object with enough mass to act as a lens and to bend the light from the light source. In this case, the low-mass planet acts as a lens. And depending on how much the light from the distant star is affected by the foreground object, astronomers can learn quite a bit. Only four other small rogue planets like this one have been found before. Together, these events provide strong evidence for a population of rogue planets in the Milky Way, the authors said. Due to their wandering nature, rogue planets are extremely unlikely to be able to host life. As such, they are unlikely to receive the amount of attention or research funding that exoplanets gain. Nevertheless, studying them is still useful for understanding how nature and the universe work. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you enjoyed hearing some positive news. If you did and you want to support this channel, please share this video with your friends or consider hitting the subscribe button. This is Alex, the voice of the What the Fact channel. That's all for today's episode, so stay curious and see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.